everyone, welcome back to the channel. My name is Prestige, and this is episode number one of The Road to Gold. For those of you that are not familiar with this series, or maybe you haven't seen it on my channel before, I've been doing this since Modern Warfare 3. What I like to do is get a gold gun in the game, talk about my struggles or whatever when it comes to getting that camouflage, and then of course give you guys some tips and tricks on how to do things a little bit simpler or easier. And I'm going to be honest with you guys, today we're doing the combat knife, and it was not simple or easy at all. Maybe the first 200 kills were, but when it comes down to doing those extra challenges at the end to earn gold, things can get quite frustrating. In fact, just getting regular kills can be quite frustrating when things like this happen, where you can't seem to knife somebody for the life of you, even though you're standing directly over their body or you're right in their face. For some reason, this combat knife just feels a lot different compared to previous iterations of it in the Black Ops series. One thing you're going to notice almost immediately is when you tap the trigger to knife, you're going to notice that there is a small delay. So really what you have to do is knife a couple of milliseconds before you get to your target. That way you can ensure a hit. But I don't know what it is. This is definitely the worst feeling combat knife in any of the Black Ops games. And it's rare that I say something like this, but I definitely think that the knife melee needs to be reworked or buffed or changed. Specifically because, one, there's no attachments for it. You can't put on like a quick knife or anything like that. And it just feels clunky. Moving into a double kill is nearly impossible, especially when you're getting shot at. And that's another thing too. For anybody that's been saying there's way too much health in Call of Duty Black Ops 4, your mind is about to be completely 180'd when you're using the combat knife. You're going to see just exactly how little health you have when it comes to trying to actually knife the enemies. Anyway, with that ramble out of the way, what do I like to use for my specific class setup? I'll go ahead and put it up on the screen for you. So we got the combat knife, of course. I rarely run a primary weapon when it comes to actually using this thing. When it comes down to perks, though, I like to use Engineer. That way I can see explosives and things that are in my path. I'll also use Lightweight and Cold-Blooded just in case they call in air support. It will be a little bit delayed and it'll allow me to get into a building before getting shot by the attack chopper or whatever. And then for my perk 3 slot, I like to use Ghost because you're going to constantly be running. And Tracker. Surprisingly, Tracker is really useful when you're knifing because you'll be able to quite literally stalk and kill anybody that's running from you. Plus, this will allow you to get easier backstabber medals when we come to that specific point. Now, gear is a little bit weird because I like to switch it up from time to time. In the current gameplay you're watching, I'm using body armor. You might be wondering, well, why? Well, obviously you need to get close to the enemy so you'll survive a couple of extra shots, but using body armor also hurts you as someone who's knifing because it slows down your movement speed. When you have body armor on, your movement speed is delayed. So really, it might not be that big of a benefit. Surviving one extra bullet, really, that's really all you're going to get at this point, and it's going to be completely negated if the enemy's using FMJ. So really, body armor is kind of a, I guess you would say, a novelty when you're trying to run at somebody. It's going to help you initially, but overall, it's just not going to help in the long run. If you wanted to use body armor and you're trying to complete some of those challenges, then sure, maybe right now is the opportunity or the time to do so. But the armor is really going to be more beneficial for those who aren't running head-in, for those that are actually using weapons from very far away. But really, what I would suggest, and I know I just got done saying I dislike this in yesterday's video, but really, this is the best way to do it. Use Ajax, use the equipment charge piece of equipment, and have your cooldown timer on your 9 bangs just go all the time. I like to jump into games of Kill Confirmed because you can pick up tags, whether they're your own or an enemy that has killed your teammate or your teammate killed an enemy. You're going to be constantly earning score, which means you're going to constantly cycle through those 9 bangs. Throwing 9 bangs down and blinding people, being able to run in and knife them, will not only help you get bloodthirsties, but this will also help you just get kills straight up. A lot of the time, when you're playing with the knife, you're going to notice that you're going to get a kill and then get killed. Get a kill and then get killed. Or you're just going to keep getting killed off the spawn. This happens quite frequently, because when you can't defend yourself at a range, it's just a given. That's what's going to happen. Now, once again, the body armor kind of comes into play here as well, because if you can escape the spawn, take a couple of shots, and have the body armor take the damage, then you're good to go because you're out there, you're ready to start knifing again. But otherwise, the body armor isn't going to be that big of a help. I would suggest using the equipment charge and Ajax's 9 bang. The initial 200 kills are the easiest, like I said, but the 5 challenges after can be a little more difficult or strenuous. So for roller rank, you're going to have to get 10 backstabbers. For Mother of Pearl, you're going to have to get 5 survivor medals. For the purple hex camo, you have to get 5 revenge medals. For Penthouse, you have to kill 5 enemies with their own weapon after killing them with a combat knife. And then finally, for Spectrum, you have to get 5 kills without dying 5 times. So basically, you have to get 5 bloodthirsties with the combat knife. Now, here is the good news. The good news is a majority of these challenges are actually pretty easy. Getting backstabber medals, that's just going to come naturally as you play. Getting survivor medals, that's going to come naturally as you play as well. In previous games, what I used to do was go to hardcore, jump off a very high height, and then damage myself. But in this game, what you have to do is just have under 50 health or right at 50 health, and then every single kill you get will be a survivor medal. So once you get a kill while you're significantly damaged, then you'll get that medal. But while you're running directly at somebody, they're going to be shooting at you, of course, and by the time you get that kill, you're going to get a survivor medal. So that will come super easy as well. You're probably going to finish Mother of Pearl first out of all of these challenges. Purple Hex, revenge medals, same exact thing. When you're just playing the game, running around, knifing people with your combat knife, you're going to be earning this without even realizing it. Penthouse is super easy to do in this game. Just stab somebody, pick up their weapon, and then just go kill them with their own weapon. You just gotta wait for them to spawn back in or just play like normally with the gun, and eventually you'll actually kill somebody with it. Now, when it comes to the bloodthirsties, this is where the challenge really starts to amp up. And I'm surprised they still did 5 bloodthirsties in this game. They did the same thing in Black Ops 3, but normally what I would say is go into a game like Hardpoint or Control where you know that they have to come to a certain location. You could sit there and patiently wait for them and knife them, and that might work for you. So that's one tip that I can give. Wait for them to come to you patiently. Try to camp your ass off, pretty much, and wait for them to come to the objective and just knife the enemies. If there's multiple enemies, you're going to have to really risk it for the biscuit, because it's hard to engage multiple enemies with the combat knife. But what I did personally, and I know it's going to sound boring as hell, but I played Team Deathmatch and I played Kill Confirm. Because of the way the spawns are, I'm able to sit in a certain area and kind of patrol one area. And if you're using Ajax, or say you're using Prophet even with the Seeker drone, you throw that out or you throw your 9 bang and it's going to capture somebody that's in your vicinity, hopefully. Once you get in there, just knife them, get the bloodthirsties. Or while you're working on all these other challenges, just put it in your back of your mind. Don't even worry about the bloodthirsties. Just play the game like normal, like you're focusing on every other challenge, and they just come naturally. Basically, that's what I did. That was my biggest concern when it came to this challenge, but the bloodthirsties, for me at least, ended up being one of the more easier tasks because I didn't even worry about it. I didn't even think about it. But if you really want to go that extra mile and you want to make sure that you actually get this challenge done, what I would recommend is rolling with a full team, kind of camping in one specific area, wait for your teammates to throw down their Seeker drone or use their 9 bang or use any of their equipment so they can assist you in getting these knife kills, or waiting for someone to throw down a recon dart or use their vision pulse. And when you know that there are enemies by themselves and you know you can get a knife kill, this is your opportunity to do so. At least that's what my friends did to help me with one of my bloodthirsties. So really, it's not that difficult of a challenge, but the knife itself is frustrating. It's very frustrating because it just doesn't work like the original knives did back in the past. If I had one small piece of advice for anybody that's looking to go out for this challenge, just don't get frustrated, because it's gonna be frustrating. Just try to remember, hey, you know what? Everybody else is out here using ICRs. Everybody else is out here using Titan LMGs. I am the only one here with a combat knife. You're bringing a knife to a gunfight, quite literally. And this game is not meant to go knife only. There are going to be people that get amazing gameplays going knife only. There are going to be people who get nuked out in free-for-all knife only. But for all of us regular folks who aren't, Jason Voorhees, and we can't run around a knife being so super silent, it's not impossible, but it is very frustrating. But anyway, guys, that's going to conclude this very first episode of The Road to Gold. If you guys have any suggestions for what weapons you would like to see next and maybe have your name appear on the screen, just vote down below and the most upvoted comment will be the next episode and you'll be featured in the next episode with your name on the screen. So anyway, guys, thank you so much for taking your time to watch the very first episode of The Road to Gold. If you did, drop a like on it. Subscribe for more awesome videos coming each and every day. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to click that subscribe notification button, which is right next to the subscribe button, that little bell icon. Once you do that, YouTube will actually notify you when my videos go live. All right, guys, I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.